Chris Kelka, not quite as good a kick as the last one. Colts field it, take it out 34-yard line. Will it be first and 10? So both defenses coming up big on the first series of the game. And Calgary Colts, first and 10 on their own 34. Hand off on the play to Ramsey. He's met by number 44, Travis Pelche, and a host of Thunder defenders. Loss of 3 on the play. Colts second and 13. Shotgun. Wasdell down the middle. Good defense on the play. The pass falls incomplete. Intended for Jordan Gabriel Cannon. 47, Paul Toth back on coverage from his linebacker spot. And the Colts are looking at third down, another two and out. And the Thunder defense gets off the field. Fabian back once again to kick for the Colts. Oh, bad snap goes through his legs. He's going to try to run. Tries to get the kick away. Does get it off. And it's fumbled, but the Thunder fall on it at the Colt 52-yard line. So a bad snap. Stephen Fabian does well to get the punt away, running to his right side. Does a semi-rugby kick. And boots it out to the 52 where the Thunder fall on it. And it'll be Thunder first down at the Colt 52. So Sawyer Buettner brings the troops back on for the Regina Thunder. Snap up the middle. Zone read fakes it. Tosses the ball out to the flat. Caught by Kasim Okaya. And he's tackled on the play by number 6, Niedermeyer. Net loss of about 1, second and 11 for the Thunder. Colts defense looking very good here in the opening quarter of the football game. Here's Buettner again. He's going deep downfield. Airs it out, intended for 9. That's Okaya, the receiver, ball just over his head. And good coverage again. Niedermeyer once again involved in the play. Incomplete pass brings up third down for the Prairie Thunder. Very little wind here to affect the kicking game. Beautiful day. Chris Kelkett back again. Punt formation stands at his own 42-yard line. Kelkett aiming for the corner. Ball's fielded at the 20 by number 19, Jesse Kuntz. Trying to hook up with 81, Jake Creasy. And the Thunder defense all over that one, forcing Wasdell out of the pocket. Third down for the Colts. A nice high kick. Penalty flag down on the play. Christian DeSalta is back for the Thunder. He bobbles the ball, rolls out of bounds on the 28-yard line. Penalty flag back at the line of scrimmage. Referee's trying to sort this one out. .822 left in the first quarter, still scoreless. Neither team managing to find points with two offensive series each team. It looks like the Colts are going to retain possession of the football as the penalty is on the Regina Thunder on that third down. So the Colts pick up a first down on a penalty. And they're at their own 40, first and 10. Thunder defense back on the field, sets up. Wasdell hands the football off up the middle. Pick up of 4 yards. Number one, Xavier Ramsey, the ball carrier. He's met on the play by Braxton Turnbull, D lineman. Second and 6, Calgary Colts from their 44. Wasdell once again in shotgun. He sends 3 receivers to the field. Wasdell scrambles, looks down the middle, fires, finds a target. Nice grab. Number 81, Jay Creasy, climbs the ladder, pulls that football down on the 44-yard line of the Thunder. A good throw by Wasdell and a nice catch by Creasy, finding a soft spot in the zone on the Thunder defense. Colts first and 10 on the 43 of the Thunder. Wasdell hands the ball to Ramsey. He dances around, pushed out of bounds. Thunder's 48, Tanner Smith. Pretty good run by Ramsey. Makes one defender miss and picks up 7 yards. Ball spotted on the 35 and a half. Call second and 4. Wasdell now rolls out to his right. Sits in the pocket, fires, looking down for Creasy, number 81, just out of his reach. Creasy dived to make an attempt at the football. It was a little bit overthrown. He had some room. Was on target. Wasdell just a little too high. And Colts are looking down. The unit is out. Looks like a 44-yard attempt just inside the 44 of the Thunder. Stephen Fabian trying this 44-yard attempt for Calgary, trying to get them on the board. Kick is up. Looks decent. It's a little bit wide to the right into the end zone. Thunder return it. And a pretty nice return for the Prairie Thunder. Tyson Hobrick up there. He pushes it up to the 21-yard line. So no points given up, a penalty. When all is said and done, it looks like the Thunder will take possession of the football on their own 10. So penalized for a hold on the return. And that's the indication here. So it'll be Thunder first and 10 and ball on their own 10-yard line. So Buettner once again in shotgun. This time he hands the football off. Victor St-Pierre Lavalette, the ball carrier, number 31. Not a lot of room. Slashes off left tackle, picks up 2 yards. Second and 8. Junior back again. One back offense. Lavalette leaves the backfield. Ball's fired down the middle. Picked off. Calgary Colts intercept it. A nice pickoff. Colton Burr went up and snagged that football. Regina throwing the ball out to the flat. Burr picks it off, and he brings it back to the 5-yard line of the Thunder. Colts in nice shape now in the red zone. First and goal. So Colton Burr drops back from his linebacker spot and sniffs that football out. Picks off Sawyer Buettner. Colts in now with the power line up, double tight end, under center. Ball's handed off to Ramsey, slashes down close to the goal line. He fights for about 5. He's going to be just short of the goal line. Ryland Gibb, one of the Thunder defenders there. It'll be second and goal. Both teams making substitutions here. Thunder trying to strengthen that goal line defense. Seems to be a little discussion here. I don't know if there was a no flags down on the play. I'm not quite sure what they're looking at, the spot of the ball. Well, there was an offside on the Thunder, so they're looking at whether that was more than the yardage gained. In any rate, it's second and goal from the 1. Colts come out, quarterback under center. They're in a wishbone stack look here. Quarterback keep, flags down. He pushes ahead, Wasdell. Doesn't get much of a push. Thunder D-line gets tough there. Ryland Warner had a good surge from his D-tackle spot. And they're not into the end zone, but the flag down is against the Thunder. Looks like offside. And Calgary's going to get 3 more cracks at it. It's going to be first down. .448 left in the first. Calgary first and goal from the 1. Threatening to open the scoring here. Once again, double tight end. Full backfield. Wasdell hands the ball to Ramsey. He walks into the end zone this time. Touchdown. Calgary Colts. A 1-yard run. Xavier Ramsey. And that was just a question of time as the Colts pound away 3 times in a row. And with the benefit of that offside penalty, they get another crack at it. Ramsey squirts through the left side of the line. And the Colts are on the board with 6. Convert in the Prairie Junior Football Conference is taken from where it used to be before the CFL made the change. And the kick is up and good. From the 12-yard line, as Fabian puts that one through. So Calgary Colts, on the basis of that Colton Burr interception, get good field position and punch the ball over to open the scoring. 7-0 Colts at 4:35 left in the first quarter. Fabian tees it up after the touchdown. Colts in their red and white unis. Very sharp. New uniforms this season for the Colts. Thunder in their white and blue. Absolutely gorgeous day. 26 Celsius here at McMahon. There's the kick. Straight and true down to number 8, Polis Coco. For the Thunder, he's out to the 20. Dances up to the 25, 26. And he's pushed out of bounds at the 27 of the Thunder. Injured Colt on the play made the tackle. Just trying to locate his number here. 37. Dalton Winkworth pushes Coco out of bounds. He looks to be okay as he gets up and heads to the sideline. Prairie Thunder, first and 10 on the 27-yard line. Thunder trying to rebound off that turnover on the last series. They come out in shotgun once again. Buettner, it's a toss. Pickup of 7 yards. Victor St. Pierre Lavillette, the tailback, takes the toss. Tackled on the play by Jordan Ray, number 23. Penalty flag down. Once again, a number of flags on the Thunder in this first quarter. And it is another hold. I believe that's the third holding penalty on the Thunder. Colts take the penalty. It's first and 20. Ball is going to be scrimmaged back on the 17-yard line. Thunder first and 10 there. Empty backfield. Buettner back to throw. Looks down the middle. Fires, hits Pierre Lavillette. He's out to the 27-yard line. Saint-Pierre Lavillette, Victor Saint-Pierre Lavillette, leading rusher for the Thunder in last week's game. And he's had a couple touches here tonight. He's a threat when he gets the football. He gets most of that lost yardage back, so it's second and 11. Buettner, quick throw to the flat. Ball's caught. Chris Kelkett goes up to catch it, but it's a short route. It's only a 3-4 yard route, which Kelkett, he snags the football, but when he catches it, he's on the sideline and had to step out, which leaves the Thunder 3rd and 7. And they're in a punt situation with the ball at their own 30. Sindani back on his own 40 for the Colts to receive this punt. It bounces. Sindani picks it up. He's out to the 50. Stumbles. About to out to the 55. He's into Thunder territory. Down to the 30. Still going. All the way down to the 22-yard line before tackled by Chris Kelkett. A nice return. Penalty flag drops on the Thunder 40, but it was well into the return as Richard Sindani dances for about 45 yards on that return, showing some good wheels, some nice blocking there on the punt return for the Colts as they created a little bit of a lane. Sindani finds the wall and takes it down to the 23-yard line of the Thunder. The flag is against Regina. So Colts on the move here. First and 10. And they got a little bit of momentum now after that touchdown and that big punt return. Let's see what they can do with the football. Wasdell takes a snap, hands it to Ramsey. He's got some room down to the 10. He's in! Ramsey all the way on the handoff. Around the left side of the Thunder defense. Nobody there. He goes untouched. If it was flag football, he would have scored. Xavier Ramsey, he's got some quicks. He's not very big, the diminutive back for the Colts, but he's got some wheels, and he showed him on that play. as he takes the handoff and goes 23 yards for the major. As the Colts open this one up a little bit in the first quarter. Fabian's convert is up and through. So with 2 minutes and 34 seconds left in the first, the Calgary Colts open a 14-0 lead over the Prairie Thunder from Regina. A one-play series there as Sindani returned the punt 45 yards down to the 22. And on the next play, Ramsey takes the handoff and goes virtually untouched around the left side for the major. Thunder hold an impromptu timeout, little meeting on the sideline as they try to get reorganized and refocused here after the quick score by the Colts to open up a commanding 14-0 lead. But it's still very early in the football game, 2 minutes and 34 seconds left to play. Kickoff team out now for the Colts once again. Good high kick deep, goes into the end zone, fielded by Ryan Warner. He's out to the five, looking for some room down that left side. There's cover, good coverage by the Colts. They're going to stop him in the shadows of his own goalpost. He snuck out to the five, but then it fell apart as the coverage team for the Colts got down and buried him. Good hustle by Calgary Colts. Ryan McNeely, one of the special teamers down on that tackle. And the Thunder are going to be in the shadows of their own goalposts once again, as they've had poor field position for the latter half of this whole first quarter. And Calgary's defense has been playing very well thus far in the football game. It's a good timeout on the field right now. Very hot afternoon here in Calgary, unlike the rest of the summer. So the players getting hydrated, as are our officials. They're running and working hard as they usually do. Prairie Junior Football Conference action. Here we go. First and 10, Regina Thunder. They've got the ball on their own 4-yard line. Buechner's going to take this snap a yard deep into the end zone. He hands the ball to Victor St-Pierre Lavalette, number 31. He bangs it off left tackle for about 4 yards. As the Thunder try to establish a little bit of breathing room back there. Second and 6. Sawyer Buechner. Shotgun. Looks for the quick curl route. Ball hits the ground and skips up. Intended for Greg Lamb. Just short. And another 2 and out for the Thunder. Looking at a punting situation from their own end zone. And with that last return by Sindani, maybe the Thunder are thinking about kneeling down and giving up two here. Kuntz and Sindani back on about the Thunder 45. Oh, the Thunder looked like procedure to me there. A couple guys jumped on the O-line there just before the snap. Not sure why. Especially if they were going to concede the points there. Anyways, it is procedure on Regina. They're going to march it back another 5 yards. Ball's going to be spotted on the 3-yard line. Thunder punting from the midpoint of the end zone. And they are going to give up 2 here and take a little bit of time off the clock. Chris Calcutt kneels down for the safety touch. So the Calgary defense gets some points there. Calcutt kneels down and bolsters the Colts' lead up to 16 now. 16-0 for the Colts. And the minute 13 left in the first quarter. And the Thunder having a little trouble on the road here on this Sunday afternoon thus far in the football game. But it is still early. So following that safety touch, Thunder will be kicking off the football. Christopher Calcutt handles the kicking duties for the Thunder. Tees it up on the 35. Regina look like they're having some substitution issues. Everybody's out on the field now. And here we go, get this play back on the road. It's a good kick. Headed towards Sandani, but it rolls out of bounds on the 20. So that's going to help the Colts once again as Regina kicks it into touch. And they'll be penalized for that. Calgary Colts football. First and 10. And it's going to be on the Colts' 50-yard line. So once again, the Colts with nice field position to open this drive up as we head into the last minute of the first quarter here in Calgary. 16-0 Colts. Wasdell breaks the huddle. They're in shotgun. Hands the ball to Ramsey. Looks for a crease. Nothing there. D-line this time studs up number 44, Travis Peltier. He wraps up Ramsey with no gain. Penalty flag in the Thunder backfield. Rough play is the call. And that one's going against the Calgary Colts. I didn't see the culprit on that play. It was away from the football. In any event, the ball will be spotted back on the Calgary 34-yard line. And it's going to be second and 25. So that one hurts the Colts there. Bailey Wasdell drops back from the shotgun. He runs a little draw to Ramsey. He has a little bit of space there. Picks up about 9-10. Carson Bell buries him at the 45. And it's third and 15. As the Colts play it relatively safe there. They run a draw to Ramsey. A good call. Not wanting to turn the ball over with a long throw. In any event, third down, Calgary Colts. And they're in a punt situation. Christian DeSaltas back on his own 20-yard line for the Thunder. And we got a timeout on the field with 12 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Colts 16, Thunder nothing. As we talked about briefly, both teams coming into this game 1-0 on the season. So an early indication of where the strength is going to be in the division. could be settled here today. Always exciting in the Prairie Junior Football Conference. You never know who's going to take it until the very end of the season. Last year, the Colts winning the quarterfinal in Regina against these Thunder. Back to our punting situation here. It's a high kick down to the Thunder 30, and it trickles out of bounds at about the 28-yard line. So no return on the play. Six seconds, so we should have at least one play here in the first quarter before the change ends. First and 10, Thunder. Buettner hands the ball to Laviolette. He's got a nice gain as he slashes out over the left side. Picks up about 18 yards. Victor St. Pierre Laviolette. And it's a first down for the Thunder as that ends the first quarter. And we're going to change hands at the end of one. Colts 16, Thunder no score.
Jen and Troy. She looked like far away. He's wearing a little brown shirt.
In the red zone?
Yeah. Rocks. Stroller there. So, see where the Great Clip sign is? Go straight up there.
The Great Clip. Or Gray Eagle? Oh, Great Clips. Okay. Yep. Yeah, yeah. I see him now.
In there too.
Yeah.
Stroller, that's Jen, and then Jen just went down that.
Oh, okay.
Hey, Troy was up, and
of course he was.
Running around.
That's what Christian used to do. Christian used to do that at your game. When he, like, right? We're back to football action, McMahon Stadium. Second quarter just about to begin. Colts 16, Thunder no score. Teams have traded ends. Ball's going to be scrimmaged on the 47-yard line. As Sawyer Buettner, 14, back. Here we go. Takes a little bit of a toss out to Pierre Laviolette. A nice run. He makes a Colt defender miss. He's down to the 48-yard line of the Calgary Colts. St. Pierre Laviolette showing some good wheels there and a couple good moves. He's looking like a solid running back for the Thunder. And he's been their main offensive threat thus far in the football game. First down, Thunder now into Colts territory. Pierre Laviolette again bangs it out to the 39-yard line, tackled by Niedermeyer. And Jaden Lawson assisting on that tackle for the Calgary Colts. Just short of a first down. It'll be second and one as the Thunder get that ground game rolling, which was very effective last week in their opening game. Second and one. Once again, the ball's handed off. It's a first down for Laviolette and more. He brings it down to the 21-yard line, tackled on the play. Justin Keys chasing him down from behind. There is a flag on the play. Preliminary call right there is holding on the Thunder. But yards are gained before the hold, so it's first and 10 at the 41. St. Pierre Laviolette dips and dives and jukes. He's out again, once again, close to first down yardage. Solid tackle on the play by Jordan Ray. Thunder on the move. St. Pierre Laviolette on that offensive line, providing the impetus. They're down to the Colts 30. Here he is again, Pierre Laviolette, down to the 20. Fights for extra yardage. He will not go down easy. A good tough run by St. Pierre Laviolette. Cameron Mons sticks his head in to make the tackle. It is another first down, but we have penalty flags. Rough play on the Colts and a hold on the Thunder. Once again, the Thunder being called for a hold. Penalties will virtually offset. The Thunder will pick up a 5-yard gain, basically. And we're looking at first and 10 on the Colt 25-yard line. Beating her back in shotgun, high snap, hands the ball to St. Pierre Laviolette. Bangs it straight ahead. Not as much room this time. Colts linebacking crew in there to make the tackle. Second and six, Thunder. Buehner straight up the gut. St. Pierre Laviolette, he's going to be short of the first down. Cam Mons steps up to make the tackle. A promising drive by the Thunder, all on the ground. But they're going to be a little bit short here, and it's third and three. Chris Kelkett, number 80, the field goal kicker, is out. He's going to try a 26-yarder. Very little breeze here. A very makeable field goal for the Thunder as they try to get on the board. Snap is up, and it is through the uprights. So Chris Calcutt's 26-yarder is good. Thunder break the goose egg. And it's 16-3 now for the Colts with 11:33 left in the second quarter. That was a nice drive by the Thunder as they settled things down and tried to hand the football off to their stud running back, Victor St-Pierre Lavillette. The O-line did a good job providing some room for him. But they're going to have to clean up those holding calls as they move forward in the season. Keep that ground game alive. Colts now try the ground with Ramsey. He's got a little bit of an opening and close to first down yardage as well. Picks up 9 yards. Brings the football out to the Colt 48. 49, check that. The Colt 44-yard line. Real close to first down, second and inches. Wazdell's going to put his head down, sneak it ahead. He doesn't get much there as the Thunder push back. But his forward progress was enough to move the chains for the Colts. Braxton Turnbull and Carson Bell, the big defensive tackles in there, push back on that play. But Wazdell gets the yardage. It was very short, but he does pick it up. First and 10, Colts. Shotgun flags are down. And that play is blown dead before it happens. Calgary a little anxious on the play, and we have a procedure call. Colts first and 15 from the 40-yard line. Wazdell looking for a swing pass. Gets away from trouble. He's going to scramble and run it. He dipsy doodles, dances out to the 52-yard line. Braxton Turnbull tracks him down. So Bailey Wazdell does his best Brett Favre impersonation and dances around. Picks up some valuable yardage, second and 4 for the Colts. Jordan Kuziak shaken up on the play. The trainers take a look at him on the sideline. Colts, second and 4. Wazdell getting a quick play from the sideline. And here they come in shotgun. Fakes the handoff. He's going to go deep. Ball's intended for number 19. He has it. He could go. Jesse Kuntz. Touchdown, Calgary Colts. A nice throw by Wazdell to Jesse Kuntz. Lays it out on the corner route. That's a 56-yard pass and run. Wazdell to Kuntz for the Colt major. As the Colts not afraid to go for the big one on second and short. A nice throw and catch there for Calgary. That convert is good as well. So Thunder elect to run the play again, and the Colts will line up to straight and true for Mr. Fabian, and the Calgary Colts open up a commanding 20-point lead. Colts 23, Thunder 3, 9:07 left in the second quarter. And a pretty impressive start by the Calgary Colts offense. They were buoyed by some good field position in the first quarter, but that last drive was an exceptional throw by Wasdell on the corner route to Jesse Kuntz, who catches the football in behind the Thunder defense and walks into the end zone for the major. Christian DeSaltes back for the Thunder along with Levi Paul. Check that. To receive this Fabian kickoff from his own 40 after the flag. DeSaltes takes it at his own 5. He's up to the 20. Got a little crease. He's thumped on the play. Good special teams tackle there. Checking the number on that play, 82. Thomas Bennett slices in and puts his head down, takes the pins out of Christian DeSaltes. And the Thunder will be first and 10 on their own 25-yard line. Looking to get back some of those points given up by the defense. Hand off to St. Pierre Lavalette. He's out to the 35. The 40 is still going. Lavalette fighting for extra yard. He's all the way out to the Thunder 50-yard line. Strong running by Victor St. Pierre Lavalette, the Thunder tailback. He broke two or three tackles on that run. And not an easy man to bring down, as the Thunder in pretty good shape on their own 50-yard line. First and 10. That's been the basis of the Thunder offense thus far. St. Pierre Lavalette, he gets the rock once again. Colts ready for him this time. Justin Keyes, 92, tracks him down from behind. Good penetration there by Keyes from his D-line spot. A rare loss of one for St. Pierre Lavalette. Second and 11, Thunder. This time they're going to throw the football. Buettner looking downfield to the sideline. He's got a man open. Ball's caught. Christopher Kelcutt, number 80, runs a deep stop route. Catches the ball in front of Colts defenders. A nice offensive play by the Thunder is going to give him a first down on the Colt 38-yard line. Buettner again. Hands the football off to Ethan Houts, number 34. I think that's Houts' first carry of the football game. And it's a good one. As the Thunder flexing their muscle with the run game right now. Houts picks up 8 yards, second and 2. From the Colt 30-yard line. Buettner again. He's got Houts again. He's a big back, and he bangs it out to the 16-yard line. More than enough for a first down. Jordan Ray coming over to make the tackle. Thunder on the move as they try to answer the Colts score. First and 10 Thunder on the 18-yard line of the Calgary Colts. Most of this has been done on the ground. Thunder call a timeout there. The Thunder ground game featuring Victor St. Pierre Laviolette and Ethan Houts doing a little bit of damage to the Calgary Colts defense. Colts a little slow breaking their timeout as they hustle back out onto the field. It's first and 10 Thunder. They're ready to go from the 17. Fakes the handoff, fires the football out in the flat. It's number 15. He's down close to the end zone there. It is a touchdown. Nathan 14. Check that. Maybe they're calling it out at the 1 yard line. In any event, the pass is complete to 14-15, number 15, in the flat. And he sticks his nose down and tries to get to the end zone. Pushed out in the corner of the field, right between the one and the goal line. That was a well-executed play by the Thunder as they faked the handoff. The fake handoff held the Colts linebacking crew for just a second, and then he fires it out in the flat. And 14 had some room. Ball is spotted by our officials at the 1 yard line. First and goal, Thunder. Colts trying to sub, but they can't get their man in. Flags all over the place. Houts the ball carrier. He looks to be in the end zone, but there's penalty flags on both sides. Ethan Houts, 34, was the ball carrier. No indication of a score, but appears that the Thunder is bringing their kick team out. But we're going to sort this out. Calgary Colts were offside. It is a Thunder touchdown. Ethan Houts, number 34, crashes in, and the Colts call for the offside. So the score will stand. Chris Kelcutt boots it through the uprights. No issues there. So with 5:26 remaining in the second quarter, Thunder answer with a touchdown of their own. It's Colts 23, Regina Thunder 10. So what started off as a little bit of a defensive struggle the first couple series, both teams flexing their muscle on offense the last two series. Calgary in the air and Thunder on the ground. .5:26 remaining in the second quarter. we've got a two-score football game. Shorter, choppy kick. Fielded by Kuntz, 19. He brings it out to the Cole 29-yard line. First and 10. Colts ball just nudging the 30. And we'll see what the offense has in store this series. See if they can answer that Thunder drive. Wasdell takes the football, hands it off to Ramsey. Off the right side, Dipsy Doodles for a pickup of about 4 yards on the play. Tackled on the play by 47, Paul Toth. He trips up Ramsey from his linebacker spot. Second and 7, Calgary Colts. Wasdell drops back from the shotgun. Good protection. Steps up in the middle. Throws the ball just under throwing. Tries to go across the middle on a little crossing route. Ball's off the turf. And the Colts are 2 and out. So 3rd and 7, Calgary kicking from their own 20. It's a high spiral kick coming down at the 30-yard line. Fielded by Christian DeSaltes. And he has a return of 14. So Regina with 4 minutes left. 1st and 10 on their own 44. Coming off an impressive drive. Their last series. They keep it on the ground. Pierre Lavalette, he's out to the 52. Tackled on that play by Lawson, Jaden Lawson, number 48 of the Calgary Colts. Close to first down yardage for St. Pierre Lavalette. 2nd and 1. Buehner back, one back offense. He gives it to Lavalette. This time the Colts are there. Good penetration into the backfield. Mike Bright. 39 wraps up Pierre Lavalette. It's a loss of yardage. That's a big defensive play for the Colts. Late in this quarter, as they're going to get the football back. As the Thunder face 3rd and 4 now. They finally got some D-line penetration to stop that run. And Regina is forced into a punt situation. It looks like a fake. It's snapped to Houts. Good time to fake it. And he's going to pick up the first down. And more. He's still going. Ethan Houts all the way down to the Colt 23-yard line. So the Thunder pull a little magic out of the hat. You could kind of see that one coming. It was the perfect time for a fake late in the quarter. And Ethan Houts, 34, takes the direct snap. Picks up the first down. Looks like he's tackled after a gain of about 7 and then releases and breaks it all the way down to the Colt 23-yard line. A big play for the Thunder. A Let's see if the Colts can dig in and hold them here. First and 10 from the 23. Buettner hands the football to St. Pierre Lavalette once again. Calgary left side of that defensive line stiffens up there. Dylan Niedermeyer steps up to make the tackle. He's assisted by big Chris Pete Schwartz, number 93, stepping out from his D-tackle spot. Second and 11. As Calgary finally stops the run. Looks like a passing down for Buettner. He steps back, fires the ball into the end zone. It's good coverage on the play. Oh, almost caught by Chris Calcutt. He was blanketed on the play by the Colt defender there, Niedermeyer. But the Thunder go for the end zone there on second and 11. And the Colts' coverage is equal to the task. Thunder line up for the 31-yard field goal attempt. Or do they have another fake in mind? I would think they would take the points. And it is a good kick through the uprights for a number 80, Chris Calcutt. Having a busy afternoon today, receiving the football as well as kicking. And his 31-yarder is good. And the Thunder close a little bit closer to the Colts. 23-13 for Calgary with 2:12 remaining until the interval. Bailey Wasdell sets up shop with the Colts, fakes the handoff, fires the ball. He's got a curl route. He's got a man open. Jake Creasy running that curl route. It's a first down for the Calgary Colts. Good pass by Wasdell. Nice protection on the play. Steps up, finds his receiver in space. And Colts move the chains. First and 10 on their 50-yard line. One back offense. Wasdell tosses it to Ramsey. He's out to the midfield, spins, and he's brought down by Brock Sitch, 13 of the Thunder. First down, or a little bit short of a first down. Second and 1. Pickup of 9 for Ramsey. Empty backfield this time. Wasdell going deep down the sideline. He has a man, but that one sails out of bounds. Intended for Richard Sindani, number 12, as he was running a go route right down the sideline. And Wasdell and him just failed to connect as the ball sails out of bounds. I like the call on second and 1. And on third and 1, the offense stays out on the field with a minute 35. Calgary, a little bit of a gamble here, as they're going to go out and try to get that first down. That looked like somebody jumped on the left side of the Colts line. I think it's a procedure. I don't think Regina jumped. But our referees will straighten things out here. Maybe Calgary trying to get them to jump. It is procedure against the Colts. And with that, it looks like the Thunder will get the football back with some time here in the first half. Minute 34 on the clock, which is eons in the Canadian game. Colts punting. Nice high punt. And it's in good shape. Sails out of bounds on the Thunder They're going to spot it at the 13, a little bit higher up. They're going to spot it at the 17-yard line as that kick sail out of bounds. With 1:27 remaining in the half, Thunder will be first and 10 from their own 17. Much of the Thunder offense has been through Victor St-Pierre Lavalette. Are they going to hand the rock off to him or throw with a little bit of time? Here's Buettner. He's going to fire a curl route. It's caught. Caught on the play by 14, number 15. Good coverage and tackled by Ryan McNeely of the Calgary Colts. Calgary willing to give up those little under routes with this much time left. Does pick up 7, leaving a nice 2nd and 3 for Regina. Buettner fires out to the flat once again. This time, Greg Lamb on the receiving end of that pass. Tackled on the play, Jordan Ray. Regina content to take those little under routes as Calgary's going to drop off in a little bit of prevent defense here. With under 1 minute to play in the first half. Empty backfield again. Buettner throws a slant route. Caught. Christian DeSaltis catches that slant route and picks up some yak yards. He's out close to midfield. They're going to be at the 52-yard line. Can the Thunder get into field goal position or more before the half here? Once again, empty backfield. Buettner in the pocket. Scrambles out to his right. Fires the football. He's got a man open. Oh, that one's just underthrown as the ball skips off the 35-yard line. He had a man open, but he couldn't get enough on the throw. And he appears to be shaken up on the play. The quarterback, Sawyer Buettner, number 44. I'm not sure if he got hit or just slipped on the play as he fired the football a wee bit short of his intended receiver. Medical staff out to check him out. Regina staff looked to be questioning and looking for a call on that play. There were no flags down. I'm assuming Buettner got hit late. As we don't have benefit of replay. He looks to be okay. Shakes it off, gets up, and runs off on his own steam. So that's good news for the Regina player and the Regina football team, as he's having a good afternoon. Quarterback Sawyer Buettner, number 14. Shakes off the cobwebs, but he's got to go off for a play. Brock Sick in now, number 13 at quarterback. He's going to take his first snap, roll out. He's under some pressure, fires the football downfield, intends it for Levi Paul. That's just over his head. And we have another flag down. Maybe that Calgary defense a little too intent on getting after the quarterback there, Brock Sick. The call does go against the red and white Colts. So Regina still has some life here as the seconds tick off towards the first half. With the penalty, it's 1st and 10, Thunder. From the Cole 42. Brock Sick, number 13, empty backfield. He's going to fire a quick pass. He's got a man out in the flat. It's number 80 of the Thunder, Culcut. He tries his best to get away from the Colt defense, but he swarmed under good pursuit. Justin Keys comes over to finish him off. Jordan Ray also in there on the tackle. Second and four, Thunder call the timeout with 19 seconds on the clock. So Brock Sick, or might be Sitch. I apologize if it's Sitch, but Brock Sitch is in at quarterback now as Buettner went out with an injury. He's completed a couple of short passes here. He's got the Thunder down to the Colt 36-yard line. Second and four. Brock Sitch throws the curl route. A nice catch on the play by DeSaltes. Chris DeSaltes, 88, climbs the ladder. And he hangs on to the football. That's just a great catch. And the Thunder are rolling here down to the 27 of the Colts. There's only 9 seconds left. Might have time for two plays. Buettner back into the football game. He's under pressure, and he gets sacked. Mike Bright with the pressure there for the Colts. And that was pretty timely for Bright. As Regina has 1 second on the clock. So they might be trying the long field goal attempt here, I would think. But good pressure from that Calgary D line as they anticipated the pass. And Bright worked his man and got in and made the sack. So the Thunder drive stalls. And they'll try the 42-yard field goal. Calcutt, number 80, the kicker. It's within his range. He's got a good leg. It's a low kick, drives it, but he drives it straight through. Good kick by Calcutt. Almost a soccer style, just drives it straight ahead. Splits the uprights, and the Thunder put up another 3 to end the half. At the end of the first half, Calgary Colts 23, Regina Thunder 16.
Christian went to YouTube. Could he see this?
Yep.
What does it go to? Colts?
Colts versus Thunder. Or it's on the Colts website.
I'll tell him. Well, so, I don't care, but just... Kid, right?
Yeah, Dallas is playing 17. There's lots.
Yeah,
Xavier, Bailey.
That's what's his face, right?
Kendrick, 29.
I put this on. So
yep. Reese, Samson, 27. Tang.
We are back at McMahon Stadium, Calgary Colts, kicking the football off to start the second half. Kickoff returned by Polis Koko, number 8 of the Thunder. He's out to the 19-yard line, and it'll be Thunder 1st and 10 from their 24. Check that, their 24-yard line. Once again, we're just into the second half here at McMahon Stadium. Prairie Junior Football Conference action. Game 2 for both these teams. Colts 23, Thunder 16. First offensive series of the second half. Hand off to Victor St. Pierre Lavalette. He did a lot of damage in the first half. No gain there as he's snowed under by the Calgary Colts. Justin Keys, 92. I'm sure the Colts talked about that at halftime, trying to stop that vaunted Thunder run game as they pounded the ball pretty good in the first half. No gain there for Lavalette. In fact, it's a loss of 1, 2nd and 11. Buettner back to throw, fires the ball. He's got a man open. 21, Greg Lamb running a little curl route. He's got a gain of 8 yards. Brought down on the play by Jordan Kimbemba, number 9 of the Colts. It's 3rd and inches. Thunder gambling early in the second half. Leave the offense out on the field. Buettner puts his head down. Quarterback sneak. He drives it ahead. What appears to be first down yardage. So the Thunder come out. And they are determined to keep the ball as they gamble on 3rd down. And Buettner does pick up enough for the first down. Sawyer Buettner was shaken up a little bit in the end of the first half. But he's obviously back and ready to play. Hand up off the middle. Pierre Lavalette once again the ball carrier. A nice gain on the play of about 8 yards. Colts Jordan Ray drags him to the turf. Second and 3, Regina. Empty backfield. Buettner throws a quick slant. It's caught by 88 DeSaltels. He fights for yardage. He's still going, but I believe he stepped out of bounds on about the Colt 50. And the play was blown dead. An official is down, shaken up there on the play. I didn't see what happened to that official there, but he is obviously in a little bit of distress, and he gets some medical help. A nice pass there by Sawyer Buettner, number 14, the quarterback of the Thunder, as he's back leading his troops once again. As we said, he was shaken up in the first half, and number 13, Brock Sitch, came in relief, played pretty well through a couple of completions. And obviously, Buettner was okay as they looked at him at halftime, and he's back leading the troops in the second half for Regina. Thunder down one major here, 23-16. Just into the third quarter, 12-22 remaining, and we have a delay of play here on the field as a referee, one of the officials, was shaken up. He's to his feet now. You don't see that very often, but occasionally the players make contact with an official inadvertently. And it seems to be favoring his leg, but he's going to stay out there. And we're ready to play football again. First and 10, Thunder. Ball on the Colt 54-yard line. Referee blows the time in. Buettner's got a one-back offense. He goes trips to the boundary, tosses it to Pierre Laviolette. Sneaks down to the Colt 50. He's met by three or four Colt defenders there, as they're ready for that run attack, as they featured a lot of it in the first half. Austin Daisy was in on that play for the Colts. First year Colt player out of St. Francis High School. Buettner back now, fires the football out to Pierre Laviolette. He catches it down to the Colt 40-yard line. Victor St. Pierre Laviolette, number 31, the tailback, showing that he has some diversity. He can step out and catch the football as well as run it. He's a big part of that Thunder offense, which is on the move down to the Colt 40, first and 10. Buettner once again tosses it to St. Pierre Laviolette. He's got some room. He's down to the 40, to the 35. Nice tackle on the play, sneaking up from his DB spot. Kendrick Ankema, number 29, takes the pins out of Victor St. Pierre Laviolette. And Laviolette seems to be shaken up on the play. That was a hard tackle, jarring him just below the knees. It looked like he had a lot of room, but a nice defensive play by Kendrick Ankema to hold the Thunder running back to 5 yards. Second and five now on the Colt 36. Buettner's going to throw it. Once again, he's got a man open, a curl route. Down to the Colt 20-yard line. It looked like Ethan Houts, number 34. It was Houts there. He stepped in for Pierre Laviolette and catches the football out of the backfield. And that is another Thunder first down. And we have a timeout on the field, as we have a couple of players down in a little bit of distress here. Number 80, Calcutt, one of the key receivers for the Thunder, is down, as is Kendrick Ankema, number 29 of the Calgary Colts. Looks like lower leg injuries. Might be a little bit of cramping on a hot afternoon like this. Ankema is to his feet, jogging off on his own steam, so he looks to be okay for Calgary. And Calcutt is still down close to the Regina bench. 23-16 Colts, 10-14 left in the third quarter in what's been a very entertaining football game here this afternoon in the Prairie Junior Football Conference. Game two for both these teams. Both teams coming in at 1-0. So someone's going to 2-0 and someone's going to 1-1. Players off the field, substitutions in. We're ready to roll. First and 10, Thunder from the Colt, 21, empty backfield. Buettner back to throw. He's got some time. Fires it to the corner. He's got a man. Oh, my, what a catch by Levi Paul. It's a touchdown. A flag went down as soon as Paul caught it. He stretched out. I didn't think he'd reach that one. And he stretched out to snag it and bring it down. A beautiful catch. Once again, flags down. Colt players are pointing to Regina to indicate an offensive pass interference. I didn't see a push-off, but there may have been one. And it appears to be. It is offensive pass interference against the Thunder, which will negate that grab by Levi Paul on a nice corner route that would have tied the football game. But the football comes back to the 36-yard line. And it'll be first and 25 for the Prairie Thunder. And they go three receivers to the field side. Buettner back to throw. He goes straight down the middle. Has a man, but he overthrows him. Number 15, Nathan Fortin. And that ball just sails over 14's outstretched arms as he was running a post as they try to sneak in behind the Colt defense there. Second and 25. Not a lot of second and 25 plays. We'll see what the Thunder have in mind. Buettner fires the ball. Caught by Levi Paul once again. Running a deep out route. Tackled immediately. Colton Burr over there to make the play for the Colts. Gets a good chunk of yardage back, about 15 yards, but that will still leave the Thunder third and 10. Now, Chris Calcutt does the field goals for the Thunder. He was shaken up on the play, so it appears to be the receiver Greg Lamb, number 21, on to do the kicking duties. He's going to try the 28-yarder for the Thunder. He hooks that one to the right. Lamb didn't get a good piece of it, kind of shanked that one to the right. It rolls through the back of the end zone for the single. So the Thunder drive is stopped there by the Colts, and that penalty really hurt them there. They go from a touchdown to a field goal all the way down to 1 point. So the Colts hold 23-17 at the 8:53 mark in the third quarter. So that injury to Calcutt perhaps hurt them there, as their regular field goal kicker was not on the field for the attempt. And early in the football season, that's always a tough call to ask the backup kicker to come in. Colts now first and 10. Wasdell at the helm, still fires down the middle. He's got Richard Sandini goes up to snag the football. Nice crossing route down the middle. Picks up 20 yards. Ball goes out to the 55 right at midfield. First and 10, Calgary. Bailey Wasdell having a good afternoon. Steps back, fires again. They try the slant route this time. It was well covered. Jake Creasy was the intended receiver. And the Thunder's Tyson Halbrook, 25, was all over him. Second and 10, Calgary. Wasdell again looks for the quick little hitch. He's got a man, Jesse Kuntz, the recipient of that first half touchdown pass from Wasdell. This time takes a little hitch. Picks up about six, but it's not going to be enough for a first down. And Calgary looking at a punt situation, try to play the field position game here. Stephen Fabian, number 8, the Colts kicker. He's got a strong leg, and he powers that football out of bounds. He's aiming for a little bit deeper than he got it, but a pretty good kick nonetheless. And it goes down to the 18-yard line of the Thunder before going into touch, and the Thunder will be first and 10 from their 18. Six-point ball game right now, 23-17. And Regina's offense back out. High snap. It's fielded as a toss to St. Pierre Lavalette. He gets outside wide, but he's brought down by Colts Justin Keys after a short gain. Victor St. Pierre Lavalette getting the bulk of the touches here today for the Thunder. Once again on the toss play there. Second and 4 for Regina. Sawyer Buettner at quarterback, shotgun. Penalty flags down. They hand the football off to Ethan Hounce. He's nowhere near a first down as he's brought down by Keys once again. Having a good afternoon from his DN spot, number 92, Justin Keys. Calgary a little anxious on that play as they're called for the offside. And that's going to continue this drive for the Thunder. That'll be an automatic first down. Thunder, first and 10 on the basis of that penalty being applied. Football at the 29. Buettner back, empty backfield, throws the football. Caught. Nathan 14, number 15, across the middle. Tackled by Colton Burr. He picks up 2 yards. Regina throwing the ball on first down, one of the rare times that they've done that in the football game. Now looking at a second down and 8. Once again, empty short passing game here. Nathan 14 catches it, makes one man miss. Turns the corner, pushes the ball up to the 50-yard line. Jordan Ray finally brings him down. But Nathan 14, again, having a nice afternoon. A couple receptions for Nathan. And Regina relying on that quick pass game and the run game. And they got the Colts back on their heels a little bit here. First and 10, Thunder on their own 49. Toss goes to St. Pierre Lavalette. He's out to the 50. Chased down by Colton Burr, number 3. That's a good tackle to catch the speedy running back. Before he can do any damage, he picks up 2 yards. Colton Burr, number 3, Colts defender all over the field this afternoon. Second and 8, passing situation. Buettner looks down the middle, fires into coverage. Penalty flag drops down. Ball was intended for Levi Paul. good coverage there by a trio of Colts defenders. Kendrick Nkama and Jordan Ray were around the football as it sailed over Paul's head. Didn't see a lot of contact there, but the referees have a flag down, and it will be pass interference against Calgary Colts, which is a first down for the Thunder to keep this drive going here in the third quarter. And there is the official call, PI on Calgary. So Regina is now on the Calgary 43.5. They're first and 10, and they're looking for the equalizing score here on this possession. Fake handoff up the middle. Pass goes out to Paul on the flat. He's down to the Colt 34-yard line. Banged out of bounds by Jordan Ray, number 23. Once again, the short passing attack of the Thunder, very effective. They're just nickel and diming the Colt defense, taking what they can get. And what they have is another first down to the 33-yard line. Buettner goes four receivers to the boundary and one man to the field. They're going to run to the boundary with St-Pierre Laviolette. Makes the first man miss. Then he's stacked up at the 28-yard line. Justin Keyes in on the stop for the Calgary Colts. Pickup of 3 yards. There's a shaken up Calgary player on the field. Injured player appears to be Chris Pete Schwartz, 94. And he appears to be okay as he walks off field on his own steam. Good to see for the Calgary Colts defense. Second and 6 now, Thunder. Ball on the Calgary 28-yard line. Buettner steps out to his right, looks down the middle, fires. Incomplete. Pass intended for Greg Lamb. Ball was thrown a little bit behind him on that route, and he could not bring it in. Third down for the Thunder. And once again, another Calgary Colt player is down. Again, a very warm afternoon in Calgary. 27 Celsius at game time. So a lot of these players probably feeling the effects of that heat. Three minutes and 27 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Colts 23, Thunder 17. In what has been a very entertaining football game thus far in the Prairie Junior Football Conference. Winner of this game will step into first place, although it's early in the season. And we have the Colt player still down and getting some medical attention. And now he's up to his feet. That's Justin Keyes, 92 D lineman. Justin Keys has a number of tackles today. He's been a very involved member of this Colt defense this afternoon, and they don't want to lose him. He's walking off under his own power, and again, might be a heat-related problem. As the Thunder line up for the field goal, trying to chip away at this Colts lead, which they've been doing here since the middle of the second quarter. Calcutt's back in to try the field goal. It's a 36-yarder. He bangs it pretty good, and it drifts to the right. It's wide. Colts are going to run it out. They're not going to give up the single. And Richardson Danny takes it out. Flag down. There's a little bit of extracurricular going on after the field goal attempt between the Calgary Colts number 9 on the play there. It's Jordan Kimbamba. And I believe Taylor Meyer was involved from the Thunder. I'm not sure what the call is going to be. In any event, there was no scoring on the play as the field goal sails wide and Calgary returns the football out to about the 6-yard line. Referees indicating the call is on the Colts. Now, I don't know if that penalty occurred after the kick and they will retake it, or if Calgary will get the ball deeper in its own end. We'll let the stripes sort it out. Well, there's 3 balls on play, 2 against Calgary, 1 against Regina. After all is said and done, it is 1st and 10, Colts. And the referees want a quick little meeting, make sure everything is right. And they seem satisfied now. Here we go. 1st and 10 from the 15-yard line. Wasdell empties the backfield. Back in shotgun. Steps up. Throws the ball deep downfield. He's got a man. Richard Sandini. He's caught it. He's out to the down to the 50-yard line of the Thunder. Tackled on the play by Tyson Halbrick. Richard Sandini. A nice reception there from Wasdell. It's a big pickup for the Calgary Colts. They're down at the Thunder territory at the 47. Wasdell is going to hand the football up the middle this time. Penalty flag drops down. Ball carriers Jordan Gabriel Cannon. That's his first carry of the football game. It's good for about 6, but Calgary looks to be penalized on the play. It is a holding call against the Colts, which will negate that run by Gabriel Cannon. Colts will repeat 1st down, this time 20 to go. Ball on the Colt 52-yard line. Colts up 6 with 2:25 in the third quarter. Wasdell, once again, back to throw. He looks down the sideline. Good coverage here. Nobody open there as he's looking downfield. Marcus Hall, number 10, the Regina defender on the play. Dylan Schrott was the intended receiver, number 7. I think that's the first ball thrown in Schrott's direction tonight. But Regina would have none of it. And it's 2nd down. Thank you. Dylan Wasdell, once again in the shotgun, fires the ball. It's a nice throw deep. It looked like his receiver was held up or he got off his route. As he just stopped running, it looked like, but ball, in any event, falls incomplete. And the Colts are looking at a punt situation.
Yeah, so I switched it out, and then it's just shooting black, so do I have to just reset one part of it, or?
Colts in a punt situation. They're on the 52-yard line, their own 52. Snap is back. Oh, it's not a very good kick. Goes off the side of his foot down to the Regina 23.
Yeah.
And some fisticuffs, not fisticuffs, but some extracurricular pushing, shoving, rough play after the ball sails out of bounds. Things getting a little chippy here on third down. Colts punt, ball rolls out, spotted at the 20. And then some late hits. It'll be first down, and this drive will continue. So Calgary was in a nice position there to get the ball back in good field position. But as it is, penalty flag on the Colts defense. And the Thunder drive continues. First and 10 on their own 20. Buettner hands the ball to Pierre Laviolette. Colts defense ready for that. Colton Burr brings him down after a short gain. Pierre Laviolette, tailback. Lots of touches today. And once again, a big part of that Thunder offense as the ground game has been very successful today. Not so much on that play. We're looking at second and 8, Regina. Passing situation. Buettner takes the snap. Fires the curl route. Complete. 88, Christian DeSaltels. He's fighting for yardage. Ball seems to have come loose late in the play. No indication that it's Calgary's. It looks like Regina has retained possession. As that football was caught, it's going to be a little bit short of a first down. But Regina will still have the football. Be third down as the third quarter ends. Calgary Colts 23, Regina Thunder 17. And we're pretty much set to go here for the fourth quarter of Prairie Junior Football Conference action. The Regina Thunder and the Calgary Colts. Colts up 23-17 as we get into the last 15 minutes of the game. Very entertaining game on a beautiful afternoon here at McMahon Stadium in Calgary. Thunder looking at a punt situation to open the quarter. And they're back at their own 25. Kick is a high one. Fielded on the run. Colts out close to midfield on that punt return. They'll have nice field position to start this next drive. Sandini, the punt returner, excuse me, number 12 on the play, Richard Sandini. First and 10, Calgary, the ball just nudging midfield. Colts up 6 points, would desperately like to increase that lead. Has the Thunder been knocking at the door lately? Ball's handed off to Ramsey. Squirts down the left side of the line. He's into Thunder territory before being tackled. Very close to a first down yardage for Ramsey and the Colts. Be second and short. Calgary likes to go deep on these second and short situations, as they've shown a couple times today. And they're going to fire the football out to the flat again. It's caught. Dylan Schrott, number 7. He runs a quick out, catches the football, picks up about 8 yards. Colts march it down to the 41 of the Thunder. First and 10. Wasdell gives the ball to Ramsey straight up the gut. And he gashes the Thunder defense there for about 13 yards. Marcus Hall tackles Xavier Ramsey, number 1. But it's a nice gain for this little scat back out of Bishop McNally Lacombe. Wasdell takes a snap. It's high. He pulls it down. Fires the ball to the corner. He's got a man. Number 12. It's a touchdown. Richard Sindani in the corner of the end zone just beyond the goal line. Wasdell lays it out over the shoulder catch. A nice grab by Sindani. He's had a heck of an afternoon from his wideout spot. Colts march that ball downfield. A very impressive drive at a critical time in the football game. Yeah, it's wrong. Colts are going for two as Wasdell again looks to the corner of the football field. Oh, just out over the outstretched arms of Dylan Schrott, number 7, in the far corner of the field. And a late flag well after the ball hit the ground. And the back judge in the corner of the field throws the flag late. So with the touchdown but the unsuccessful two-point convert, Colts increase their lead to 12. Colts 29, Thunder 17. Flag was on the Regina Thunder, so the ball is moved up to midfield for this kickoff. As Fabian tees it up on the center stripe. Kick into the end zone. Polis Koko, number 8, takes a knee. And the Colts get a single back to make it a 13-point lead. Calgary 30, Regina 17. Thunder offense will come out. First and 10 for Regina on their own 35-yard line. And they're looking to answer the Colts' score here. Buettner tosses the football to St. Pierre Lavalette. Makes one man miss out to the 40, down to the 43-yard line. A nice gain, tackled by Jordan Kimbamba. Chains are close to a first down yardage, second and 1 for the Thunder. Thunder huddling up here. And they go trips to the wide side. Buettner calls the football. Standing there, rolls out to his left. He's going to run. Takes off, gets out to the 47-yard line where he's met by 3 Cole players. Chris Pete Schwartz, number 94 there, to stop Buettner's forward progress, but he does pick up enough yardage for the Thunder first down. Regina on the move here. Empty backfield. Buettner steps in, fires a slant behind number 88 DeSaltels. He appears to have made the catch, but goes down upon catching the football right away. Picks up half the required yardage. Second and 5, Regina. Sawyer Buettner, number 14, takes the snap. Second and 5. He finds his tailback, St. Pierre Lavalette. He's got a little bit of room to ramble down to the Colt 39-yard line. Dylan Niedermeyer snags his leg and pulls him down. But that's a big first down for the Regina Thunder, who are on the move here. Sawyer Buettner, once again, empty backfield down the middle. He's got a man open. Oh, it's picked! Stepping in to pick that football, Dylan Niedermeyer. And he's brought down by Levi Paul. That's a big defensive play for the Calgary Colts. Dylan Niedermeyer, looked like the Thunder had a man wide open, and Niedermeyer steps in front and snags the football, stopping that Thunder drive in Colt territory. A good defensive play by the Calgary Colts there. That could be a game changer with 10 minutes left and a 2-score football game. And once again, we have an official shaken up. That's the second time in today's game. I don't think it's the same official. So a rough afternoon for the black and white stripes here at McMahon. That's 2 interceptions today for the Colts. At key times, the first one by Colton Burr setting up a Calgary touchdown in the first half. And now Niedermeyer snuffing out the Thunder drive that was looking pretty promising for Regina. But it'll be Colts football once this football game resumes. So once again, back at McMahon Stadium, you're looking at the Calgary Colts Regina Thunder game, and an official is being helped off the field here. It does not look like he'll be able to continue working this game as he was caught up in the play there and appears to have a lower body injury of some sort. Colts staff will look at him. Calgary Colts, after that pickoff, are first down at 10. On their 31-yard line, Dylan Wasdell at quarterback, hands off to Ramsey. He's got some wheels, goes to the wide side. He's all the way to the midfield line. Stops, cuts back into Thunder territory. Big pickup for number one, Xavier Ramsey. Finally brought down on the play by Tanner Smith of the Thunder. It's a 27-yard run for Mr. Ramsey as he scoots around the left side, all kinds of green grass in front of him, and he takes advantage of his speed, turning the corner for a big pickup. Colts now first and 10 into Thunder territory. Once again, up to Ramsey, straight up the middle. That's not his forte, right up the gut. Number 47, Paul Toth, and a host of Regina Thunder defenders there to put the brakes on Ramsey. He picks up maybe two on the play, second and eight for the Colts. Ramsey more of an outside run man, but the Colts not afraid to try the middle. And Wasdell looking to throw here on second down. Down the sidelines, got a man. Number 12, Richard Sindani. Sweet hands of Sindani this afternoon. He catches the football down on the Thunder 20-yard line over top of number 18, Robbie Lowe's of the Thunder. Sindani, the recipient of the last Colt touchdown in the corner on a little flag route. This time he catches it on the sideline, and he puts the Colts in great field position. Give to Ramsey on first down, out over the right side, breaks one tackle. Second man brings him down on the 18. Braxton Turnbull, the defender, to pull down Ramsey after a gain of 3 yards. Colts huddle up, break the huddle ball on the 18. Far right hash. All kinds of motion. Wasdell scrambles to his left, sets up, throws in the end zone. Oh, he had a man wide open. Dylan Schrott, ball goes into his hands. He's wide open. It's a touchdown, but Schrott drops the football. Tough break for Dylan there, as Wasdell had him wide open. And that would have put a dagger into the Thunder's hearts. Colts content now to try the field goal to get something out of this drive. It'll be a 24-yard attempt. Stephen Fabian, the field goal kicker for Calgary, lines up, pounds it straight, high and true. It's through the uprights for Fabian, the 24 yarders successful, Colts 33, Thunder 17, with 6 minutes and 56 seconds remaining in the football game. Good for Calgary to get some points on that drive. They didn't want to come away empty-handed after stopping Regina with an interception on the last series. That was a big series for Calgary. So Thunder needing 2 touchdowns and 2 two-point converts to climb back into this football game, and they got to do it in 6 minutes and 40 seconds. Buettner back on first down, fires down the middle. No way, this one's picked off again. Colton Burr, number 3, that's his second. Colton Burr just playing center field there. Picks off Buettner's pass. His second interception today for Colton Burr. And he slides in on the return into Thunder territory as well. So the Calgary defense steps up to the occasion. 2 times in a row, the last 2 series, interceptions. And if they can get some points off this, that could seal the deal here today. At McMahon with 6 minutes left. First and 10, Calgary content to keep it on the ground to Ramsey. He's got a little bit of space. Again, he's shifty, he makes a move. A nice run by Xavier Ramsey. He's down to the 20-yard line. It's a 25-yard pickup for number 1, Xavier Ramsey. Again, having a big afternoon here against the Thunder. As Calgary's diversifying their offense a little bit. Really a nice mix of run and pass today. And the defense has certainly done their part with 3 turnovers. Thunder player shaking up on the play there. Robbie Lowe's, but he's walking off to the sideline on his own. The red and white, Calgary Colts, first and 10 on the Regina 20-yard line. Wasdell hands the football up in the middle of just off the left side of the Colt offensive line. Running that time, this Christian Sherman, that's his first carry of the football game. Christian Sherman, number 22, picks up 6 yards. Bailey Wasdell gone all the way at quarterback. He got his troops down into scoring territory. Flag down. And this play is whistled dead before they can get it off. Calgary called. A little anxious to get that play off. Procedure against the Calgary Colts. Second and 10. Colts from the Thunder 20. Bailey Wasdell takes the shotgun snap. Looks out to the flat. Ramsey catches it. Regina had this one read immediately. Robbie Robertson, 54, thumps Ramsey as soon as he catches the football. Calgary lucky not to turn that one over, as Robertson would have had a lot of room to run if he picks that off. Third down, and the Colts to try a 35-yard field goal. Fabian has been money today. Stephen Fabian, 35-yard attempt, well within his range. That one looks pretty good, and it is. He splits the uprights again. Stephen Fabian providing much-needed points with the kicking game today as the Colts increase their lead to 19 points. Colts 36, Thunder 17, with 4:22 remaining in the football game. So two big interceptions by the Calgary Colts in this fourth quarter to snuff out Regina drives. And it's pretty much desperation time now for Regina. They need a lot of points in a hurry. I suspect they'll be throwing the football, but here they hand it off to St-Pierre Lavalette. And you know he can do some damage, although it is late in the game. Cracks the ball out into Calgary territory, picks up about 20. On the handoff, Victor St-Pierre Lavalette. He's the main cog in that Thunder offense, and he's had a good afternoon rushing the football. Caught a few out of the backfield as well. And they'll go to him again. If anything, he's going to pad his rushing stats. Tough man to bring down. Gets down to the Cole 39-yard line. Tackled by Mike Bright. It's a gain of about 13. Another first down for the Thunder. And with the last couple balls being picked off by the Colts, maybe Regina's content to pound it on the ground. And nothing wrong with those two running plays. Except the clock keeps ticking. And the clock is Regina's enemy right now. They hand it off to Pierre Lavalette again. This time Calgary stuffs him. Chris Pete Schwartz, first man to make contact, big 94. He's had a busy afternoon as Regina's run the ball consistently all afternoon. Calgary players shaken up. Once again, a hot afternoon. A lot of these players probably cramping up. Two minutes and 50 seconds remaining. Thunder needs some points in a hurry if they're going to get back into this football game, but nothing's impossible in Canadian football. Colt player Mike Bright hustles off to the sideline and he looks to be okay. Buettner takes the pass, fires a hitch pass long. Intended receiver is Greg Lamb. That one sails over his head. And Thunder looking at 3rd and 10. Sawyer Buettner. Snap looks down the backside. He's got a man, 4-10 open. Oh, just off his hands, incomplete. Nathan Fortin, number 15, reaches over the shoulder to catch the football. And pretty good coverage there on the play by the Calgary Colt defender Niedermeyer, number 6. As he arrived with some heat as the football arrived. And 14 unable to secure it. So that'll turn the ball back over to the Calgary Colts. With 2 minutes and 30 seconds left, they can sustain a drive and take care of the football. Probably put this one to bed. Bailey Wasdell takes a snap, hands the ball to Ramsey. He's off the right side for a short gain, tackled by Ryan Warner. Time is in. Calgary content to run the football, take some valuable seconds off the clock. as they're in control of this game at this point. Wasdale in shotgun, one back set. They give it to Ramsey. He pulls away from a defender there. 92 had his jersey. Warner grabbed his jersey, and Ramsey pulled through it, showing some good strength there. And he picks up a first down. That's a tough little run by Xavier Ramsey. Kind of exemplifies his day here today. He fights for that extra yard, and Calgary retains the ball. I would expect to see a couple more run plays here as the clock winds down to 1:45. Once again, it's handed off. This time, Jordan Gabriel Cannon gets the carry, picks up 4 yards, maybe a little less, picks up 3, 2nd and 7 for Calgary. Good football game here today at McMahon. Calgary defense stepping up in the fourth quarter, intercepting Regina quarterback Sawyer Buettner 2 times. And those are important plays in this football game, sealing the deal for Calgary. Ramsey gets the call once again as the Colts keeping the football on the ground. Doesn't get much here. It's going to be 3rd down. Thunder will get their hands on the ball, but there's only 1:17 on the clock. Calgary Colts in punt formation, late stages of this game today here at McMahon. 3rd down. A little bit of heat there, but Fabian gets it off. Paul sails deep over Christian DeSaltel's head, but he picks it up on his own 5. He's out to about the 10. Penalty flags down. Short return of about 6 for the Thunder. They'll be deep in their own end. And once again, a penalty flag down. Holding on the return as the Thunder is going to be marched back a little bit deeper under the shadows of their own goalposts. Once again, Calgary's had good field position for most of this game. Full marks to the Colts today for the victories. The defense played outstanding. 3 interceptions by that Colt defense. And the Thunder able to run the football successfully, but not enough as they give it to their main man, St. Pierre Lavalette. Once again, he's padding his rushing stats. Picks up 5 as we're into the last minute of play here. Sawyer Buettner is going to fire it here. Oh, this one could get picked. Oh, it's over the head of the Calgary defender. Didn't look like a great toss, but it is complete to Greg Lamb. Ball sort of fluttered at the end there, but Lamb does a good job of picking it out of the sky there. And he has the catch and the football out to the 26-yard line. But it's really going to be too little too late for the Thunder. Nevertheless, they'll finish the game out. Buettner fires the ball in the flat. Quick flag there, intended for his favorite receiver, Christian DeSaltels, this afternoon. Kendrick Nkama, the victim of the flag there. He arrived just a little bit early on his back. And the pass interference call. Calgary Colts celebrating a little bit on the sidelines. A little Gatorade shower down there to one of the coaching staff. And nice to see the Colts pick up their second victory in a well-played football game here today in McMahon. Victor St. Pierre Lavalette gets the ball. And as usual, he picks up good yardage. But once again, it is late in the football game for the Thunder. As they're down 19 points to the Colts. Looks like the last play of the game coming up here. And this one will be in the books. So Buettner takes the pass. And they hand it off up the middle again to Victor St. Pierre Lavalette. Tackled on the Calgary 48. With zeros on the clock, and this one is in the books. No flags down. That's the end of this football game. Make the final. Colts 36, Thunder 17. From McMahon Stadium, you've been watching Prairie Junior Football Conference action.